Welcome to Promote, Profit, Publish. I'm your host, Juliet Clark. Before we get started today, remember to go over to YouTube and subscribe to our channel. All of these people that are on, I know you're probably listening on your podcast, but if you want to see them and see what they look like, and I'm sure you'll know a lot of them, go over to YouTube and subscribe to us at Superbrand Publishing. And don't forget to take our quiz, promoteprofitpublishquiz.com, and find out if you're really ready to publish. Do you have all the P's and Q's in order to really have a successful launch? And I bet for most of you, you don't have an audience built yet. So go find out about that. So today's guest is so much fun. We always get off on these conversations. I'm not even sure where we go half the time. He's like my little spirit animal. He reminds me sort of my dad. My dad and I used to walk in the mornings, and we would have these conversations that anybody else who was involved would be like, did you just communicate? Like, where did that go? Ken and I are kind of like that. So for over a third of a century, and he wrote this himself, most people would just say 30 years, but for over a third of a century, Ken Krell, Ken Krell has inspired thousands of people from all over the world by sharing powerful ways to create wealth and prosperity and happiness in their lives. Ken is most recently known as the producer of the Opportunity Thon, the world record setting 28 and a half hour live marathon broadcast that featured over 55 of the world's leading authorities on business, mindset, and success. The event reached thousands all over the globe and is the cornerstone of liveconferencetv.com. LCTV is known for pride, producing ridiculously irresistible digital events. You're right, you're a marketer. And Ken's three-day Pride experience gives attendees the tools needed to pivot from the physical to digital stage. And how many of you need to hear this? We all thought a couple months ago that COVID was going away, and apparently not. Ken is the founder and driving force behind Wellspring Strategies, www.wellspringusa.com, where he and his team help American taxpayers and foreign entities subject to U.S. taxes protect their assets, legally defer their taxes, maintain their privacy, and create more prosperous lifestyles. I had no idea that you even did that. That means he's smart. Wow, we need to talk about that. Now, Ken produced World Love Week, a virtual event focused on helping business owners as a force for good, and other multi-speaker digital events, including the World Info Mastery Summit, the World Speakers Summit, the World Authors Conference, and the World Cairo Conference. I don't know how that's all related, but somehow, other than the word world, Cairo fits in there. He's been respected for decades as an expert in niche marketing strategies in real estate and mortgage financing businesses, and has founded and operated several successful real estate investment and mortgage banking firms. Until recently, Ken has extensively traveled and has spoken on stages around the world, from the USA to Australia, New Zealand, Hong Kong, Thailand, the Philippines, Malaysia, Indonesia, India, Singapore, and more. And now that I've read his bio, the show is over. Welcome, Ken. Welcome, Ken. Do you have a free gift?
It was a short one. I don't think I'm
short one. That's okay. The show will now go for like 35 minutes because Ken's bio took an hour. Welcome, my friend.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
You again. And you're on my big screen. You're on my big screen in front of the camera. So I'm like, you're like live, like right there in front of me. It's awesome.
Wow. I feel like I should like perform. I don't know. What do you guys think? Close? No, never mind. Anyway, well, we're going to talk about events today because so many of us are really bummed. Except for me, I love not having to go out of the house now, but we've had to move from physical stages and traveling and hotels and bad food and no exercise to online summits, and you do them really, really well. So tell us about them.
You're taking my whole pitch. It's true. The people that are making money this year, that are being successful this year, they pivoted to digital. And those that haven't yet, because they're afraid or whatever, we'll talk about how to get over that right now. But digital, my gosh, the ability to, okay, well, I'm at my dining room table. I gave you the tour, Juliet, just before we started. Like, you pivot the camera to the right, there's my kitchen. You pivot the camera to my left, there's this beautiful view of the city. And I'm going to do this. When I'm done with this, I'm on another interview. When I do this, after that, I'm on another one. The bottom line is that on digital stages, we can maximize our time so much better. You know, I'm a traveler. I've been traveling for years, and when Juliet started going to all the different cities, you know, there's all that, but that's wonderful. And I love traveling. But when you're a speaker and you're traveling, the time that you're on the airplane, that time that you're in the Uber to the airport, the time waiting for your baggage or whatever, the time waiting for a delayed plane is dead down time. And so if you're thinking you're doing a 1 hour event in Cleveland, for example, to our US audience, you know, you're still flying from wherever it is. You've lost at least a day or two. And for me, being here on the Asia Pacific side of the planet, pretty much anywhere I go is a long flight. So when I was living in Bangkok, for example, let's just say I went back to the States to speak, not only is it 24 hours of flying time, but it's also jet lag. And by the way, it's by about 24 hours each way. So it's a disaster on the body, and the opportunity cost is gigantic. My friend Casey Epperhart, who you should interview, by the way, he's awesome. Casey told me that during my last Pride event in December, he was on 9 other stages during my weekend. 9! And typically when he would MC an event, he'd do one and that would be it, and he'd make X dollars. Now, so the ability for us, just from this, from as a speaker now, from the logistics side is gigantic. But from the economics, Juliet, think about this. We're not paying for airplanes. We're not paying for hotels. We're not paying for crappy food. No matter where you're eating, it's not food that you're making at home. It's really healthy and nutritious. Assuming you eat healthy and nutritious, another conversation altogether. You know, you're not away from your family, which, okay, right now everyone wants to get away from their family because you've been locked up with them for so long. But, you know, you get the point. The whole ability to not have spent all those thousands of dollars is gigantic. And then to the other side of it, your audience at a physical event has to get there. So they've got the hotel expense, they've got the travel expense, they've got the time away, and away from the family and the kids and all that. Then you've got, do they want to travel that far? Or if you're in Topeka, for example, and you want to run an event, first of all, you're probably not going to run in Topeka because it's not a hub city. Right. So now you've got to go somewhere else. You do with your team. So you've got all those expenses, plus the hotel expense for the meeting room and everything else, and the food, and all that, right? Plus the printing of all the physical stuff you got to deliver to everybody, and the extra staff you have to have. But is somebody from Pretoria, South Africa going to attend? Probably not. But when you're digital, all the people in Pretoria have to do, or in Nairobi, or in pick a town in Spain or whatever, all they do is boom, they're there. So your global audience is huge. The last Pride event I did, it was one of my other events, 14 countries. 14 countries, you know, I mean, and that was light, you know? So the beauty of us to be able to really go around the world is gigantic. So now we have a bigger audience at less cost, which gives us more of an opportunity to maximize and monetize. And I love those M words, maximize, monetize, and monopoly, yeah. But that gives you that freedom and flexibility. The big question though is, how do you do it in a way that keeps people engaged? Because especially now, everyone's getting zoomed out. Right. So how do you get people to sit down, stay seated in front of you? And by the way, I don't like people sitting a lot. So I have them stand up and move around, and we dance a little bit. I'm not a dancer. I bring someone in to help me with that.
me neither.
For real. Yeah. You know, and we do things that engage them. The cool thing is you don't need to spend a lot of money. Right. That's the wonderful thing. So Juliet, you asked me, what kind of backdrop are you using? Palm trees, you know, real palm trees. For those of you that live in the South and the Caribbean or whatever, I live in the Caribbean. These are weeds, you know, and I lived in Fort Lauderdale. These were weeds in my front lawn. We'd have to chop them down all the time because they grew so big. I'm in Sydney right now. And these were expensive. I'm
really?
They're expensive here. These trees were $139 Australian, which translates to about $89 US.
Wow.
They're big, but they're really good. They're nice backdrops. You don't even have to have this, but effectively you can be anywhere. And the cameras that you got, now I've upgraded my camera, but my first big event, my first Pride event was done with a GoPro, you know, so for real, it was done with a GoPro. You can use your iPhone, you can use a webcam, whatever you want. You have what you need. Zoom, you have what you need. So when I teach people how to do their events, I want to mitigate all the fear that goes with tech. Because tech, frankly to me, a tech concern is an excuse. Because if you can walk right now, you can do your event. And frankly, at the end of the day, nobody really cares about your technology. They care about you and your message. I mean, I'm not watching you, Juliet, because of your backdrop. I'm watching you because you're freaking awesome. You know, because you're, yeah.
I like my backdrop?
It's adorable, but I don't watch you for the backdrop. I watch you for you. And by the way, you look awesome today. I have to tell you before, sorry, you look really good.
This is why I have him on, you guys. He's always so full of compliments and I just eat them up. And yeah, I don't really care what he has to say. Just keep complimenting me. No.
Marketing 101, you know, stroke your host. Yeah. But yeah, you do. You look really awesome. Anyway, I got to tell you before we started. So the whole key is just show up, be real, be fun, and people will buy into you. And when I say buy into you, I'm not just talking about money, but they will buy into and enroll into your energy, into your enthusiasm, into your messaging. Because at the end of the day, it's your message that matters, right? If they accept your message, if they enroll in your message, buy into it, whichever terminology you want to use, then they will want to go further with you because they'll fall in love with you. And the big key in what I teach people is how to get them to fall in love with you. Because there really is a model to that. You and I talked about this before when we've spoken, Juliet. There is a dance. When I teach people to do 3-day events and understand, I've been doing stuff on stage. Okay, it's 39 years. It's nearly 4 freaking decades.
Okay, that's so crazy. He lied about the third. It's really more like almost 40%. Almost 40.
Over a third of a century. That is true.
Okay.
Okay.
You probably lie about your age too, don't you?
I never more. I'm proud of my age. Ask me. I'm proud of my age.
How old are you?
I am 63 years old.
Oh, you're older than me.
Uh-huh.
Wow. That's awesome.
I say, hey, young lady. I can say that. I mean, the damn problem is I'm the oldest person in the room most of the time. It's just like, what the hell is this?
Yeah.
So, yeah. I got now. I'm coming out with a fitness program. Are you kidding me?
I mean, really? Is this like COVID fitness? Actually, that's funny you said that because our latest author that just launched is Jane Fonda's personal trainer. And she, like, right at the great timing, when COVID hit, she already had this in the works. She just released a fitness program that you can do at home, online subscription. So there's a place for you, Ken.
Been fabulous over 50, been fabulous over 60. Yeah, well, we've been working on it for a couple of years. And then I kind of got off the train.
Yeah, but didn't we all? I got the little ice cream pooch from COVID. So
yeah, the other beautiful thing is no one can see that, right? So
I
got a nice clean shirt on, right? And I'm wearing shorts and I'm wearing flip-flops. You know, it's like you know, TV newscasters, they've always been doing this. They've always had shorts below the desk, you know, because no one's seen below the desk. You now have to do all this. And so you have what you need. You really do. The now the key is understanding how to dance the dance. Mm-hmm. So when I teach people our three-day model, one thing is don't bang on the mic. That's another little lesson we teach you. Don't bang on the mic. When you do, yeah, because people hear that and they go boom. So when you do the 3-day model, when you you know your objective is to go before, have them fall in love with you, and then if they want more, you invite them to join you along the journey. If you invite them too soon, they will hate you. If you invite them too late, you'll hurt yourself. So you have to learn how to do that in an appropriate way and not do it in a tacky, sleazy manner. You do it to the degree where, frankly, they'd be crazy not to continue with you because the love fest is awesome. And when you're in that, here's a beautiful thing. When you're in that state, when you and I do our thing, like now, we're not working. I mean, this is technically work. It's business. We have a business purpose. But we're having a great time. We always do together. Mm-hmm. And that's the journey I want your audiences to be on. That's what I teach you to do. Because when you stop pushing, when you stop being fake, and when you come from authenticity, and when you come from the information you really want to give out because you're coming from source, and I don't want it to sound so heady, but it really is true.
So woo-woo.
Oh my gosh, right? But that's true because people then bite. They sense your authenticity and you're not working anymore. That's the beautiful thing. You're not working anymore.
Right. Right. That is so right.
I love my Pride events. We have one coming up in just a few days, actually, which I'll tell you about in a little bit. That was when we do that, I love it. And for me, most of the time, because I'm on the other side of the world, whether it be in Bangkok or here in Sydney or wherever I just happen to be these days, who knows? It's usually nighttime. It's usually middle of the night. I don't care. It's fun. I'll stay up all night and I'll teach. It's fabulous. I have a high-end coaching program. It is a joy. I can't wait to, I keep giving them like bonus sessions. I love them because it's fun. Like by myself, I'm bored. Let's go do something, guys. So when you're in that state and you are not coming from having to work, and in the past, when I was in coaching programs, it was a labor, not a labor of love. It was a labor. Yeah. Now it's a different ball game because I've got the right people. That's another conversation to have. Mm-hmm. Right audience, because now they want what I have. They want to make that pivot. They want to recognize, how do I build a bigger audience that's global without leaving the comfort of my home? You know, how do I turn my bedroom into a profit center without violating the laws?
Wait, I know how to do that. Do you need some coaching? I never have. I'm going to be one of those coaches who's never actually done what I'm talking about, but don't worry about it. I got this.
We're not teaching pole dancing either. But if you had a pole dancing school, you could put up a pole and do video of you doing what you can.
Have you ever tried pole dancing?
I have not. However, I will tell you, this is the truth. I'm going to circus school now, and I'm doing silk.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah.
So it's actually really hard. And I always had this vision that like these out of shape, druggy girls who are basically prostitutes were the ones who pole danced. And when I tried it, I was like, there is no way that I could do drugs and not be in shape and do this. So little respect
honestly,
there.
I mean, just so I started doing silks a few weeks ago, experience of that. And then the silks, by the way, that's the Cirque du Soleil stuff. So you're climbing up and then they're all the acrobatics in the air, and it's gorgeous. It's really beautiful. And I've always wanted to do it. So I got to tell you, it's hard. It is really hard. That's hard. You know, oh my gosh. And then handstand, scary. Cause upside down is scary. But I will tell you, as a workout, best workout ever, because you're not like doing a chest press or a shoulder press. You're doing stuff that you physically have to do. You can't move your legs, you know, without solid core. So it's different. The other day, she said to me, so you need to move your leg around that. I'm like, it ain't going. You know, now there's a reason to stretch. Before, stretching was like, oh shit, that's something I'm told to do. Now it's, I can't do that move unless. So it's a different mindset. I think like 10 years ago, I lived in Atlanta, and I got to tell you, it was really, really, really cool. So it's fun. Anyway, I digress. So yeah, you could do a pole dancing training from here, as long as people can get their own pole to stick in their home and practice. You can do that. I mean, my mom's doing Zoom yoga.
Okay, I thought you were going to say your mom's doing pole dancing on Zoom. Like, what?
I want to think about. But you know what? She quite possibly could. It would be a woman, you know, she's 80. Something that you're young, and she's unstoppable. She's running around in South Florida on an adult tricycle, right? Different conversation altogether. So, yeah.
His mom is like his little bestie. So,
his mom is my best friend ever. Yeah, we just did a video of her and I. It was kind of a sizzle reel. And the beginning of it, the pictures of her, I found all these videos. I'm digressing. I shouldn't digress, but we were on the phone. You know, Apple, sometimes if you have an Apple device, they'll give you a retrospective. You know, here's some pictures of stuff from the past of you, right? And then if you click, you can have it do a 30-second or up to a 4-minute video with music. So we're on the phone or we're FaceTiming. I'm sharing my screen with her, and there's pictures of us in this album. She said, "It looks like you're celebrating my funeral."
Well, actually, now that you mention it, we did that for both of my parents' funerals. So yeah.
Well, Mom, guess what? When you kick off, guess what we're doing?
Great. Okay. So back to events.
Real second.
So a lot of people are afraid of the technology, and a lot of times you have to use Zoom webinar, but you can bring an assistant in to run that for you while you're doing this. Absolutely. I mean, if you're not comfortable, I'm perfectly comfortable doing it. But I remember at the beginning, I used to bring, my assistant used to come in and kind of man the chat and do all those things while I was presenting. So there are kind of workarounds that are in that technology.
Yeah. And you know what? There's Zoom webinar and Zoom meeting. I love Zoom meeting. And the big reason is I can see you. So when I do an event, I always use Zoom meeting. The only reason I use, yeah, for real, because now people can be on, I can have them dancing, we can all see each other. Zoom webinar is like you'll go to webinar to the degree that you can't see their faces. They can see you, they can hear you, but the only way you can communicate with them is in the chat. So the little hack I have is that if you have a really teeny little audience and you don't want anybody to know, use Zoom webinar. You know, but if you're doing a training, use Zoom meeting. All my trainings are Zoom meeting.
I use Zoom webinar, but I let everybody come on. But you bring up a good point about the dancing. We did an event back in Peace and Pivot back in April. And we actually had a happy hour and a wine tasting and a magician. So there, and the magician actually goes from Zoom call to Zoom call now. Corporations are paying her to liven up their meetings.
And she can just pivot and making more money now than ever before.
Probably.
You know, now, just as disclosure and no question that the whole COVID situation has created massive challenges for people and destroyed some families, and a lot of people have died. And, you know, I want to acknowledge that, because when we talk about the great stuff that's come from this, I don't want anyone to think that we're not being sensitive to
some of the
people have died because of this. But with any negative, whether when the forest burns down, there must be growth that comes from that. So I want to focus on the, what do you do? You know, after the devastation, what the heck do? You have to grow. That's the opportunity. So I want to be, you know, I'd be mindful of that for any of you that watching have had disappointments. And that's the understatement of the century, disappointments. The beautiful thing is, Zoom meeting. And yeah, you don't have to run it yourself. You can absolutely. I will tell you that my Pride event, I don't run it myself. I have a producer in the States. And I do that because I don't want to be focused on technology at all during my event. I don't want my students focused either on that. I want them focused on the presentation, on what the delivery is. So if something goes down, and it will at some point, there's my team to do it. Now, it's not cheap. If you use a service, I mean, I have a professional service that does this, because to me, the economics of an event, listen, these events can make you a lot of money.
Oh, yeah.
We take a look at my friend Kim Walsh-Robes, for example. Kim's first event, she had 100 people in the room, and I'm not speaking out of school, she published this, 100 people in the room, she sold tickets at $97 a piece, so do that math, that's about $10,000.
Yeah.
But she sold over $250,000 of
product
services. Yeah, product and services. It's actually more than that at this point. Her second event is significantly more than that. I'm not even going to go into those numbers. So that, you know, that should impress you on what can be done in 3 days. I'll take it down to another level. A one-day event with one of my students, Pam, didn't exactly do it the way I recommended. I mean, all the things she could do wrong, she did, right? She had a whopping 11 tickets sold. 11. Uh-huh. You think, oh God, this is a disaster. By the way, they were $25 a ticket and they all went to a charity. So right. Not a profit center. 8 people showed up. And she had multiple speakers during the day, which I don't typically advise. In the day, she had still bonded. She had 2 people that filled out applications for her $5,000 per month program. And one of them, she's negotiated a deal where it's going to be $1,500 a month and a percentage of sales. She's got an $18,000 sale. And by the way, what did she spend on that to market it? $750.
Yeah, that's about right. And I've been on summits this year where, you know, I've been really like, I show up and I'm sort of disappointed, like, there are only 9 people on this call. And, you know, 4 or 5 of them will buy because they're your serious people who need help. And they like, so, you know, while you're sitting there thinking, oh, this is going to be a waste, it actually turns out to be a pretty good thing. The only event I've done this year, we have not sold anything on. We were, that Peace and Pivot was right when COVID hit, and we were very careful to, you know, nobody was allowed to sell anything.
Yeah. With the Opportunity Fund, we kind of did the same thing. We did that specifically to give people the opportunity, the mindset that was the opportunity everywhere. Have we even had a song written, which opportunity is everywhere as part of the lyrics. So what I let them sell, I let them make an offer that was so crazy stupid that people would say, thank you, you're amazing. And we had like, out of five speakers, I think we had like 10 offers. And you know, a few dollars in sales, nothing significant, that wasn't the intention. And we talk about that when I train, because it really is a reason for why we do what we do. But the beautiful thing is, when you do it right, people say thank you. They're enthusiastic. They will find the money. And the other side of the coin is this. Even, you know, with Pam's first event with 8 people on board, she was thrilled. I mean, I got her on video. She was just, I mean, she was going from total fear and freakdom to holy macro transformation and tears of joy and, you know, and relief too. Mm-hmm. And she already scheduled the next one. Next one is taking place in just a couple of days, I believe. So it's pretty amazing, the transformation. I see this happening to my students all the time. It's like, here, and then, whoa! And, you know, for the attendees, you've got an intimate situation. Now if you're in a group of, say, 10 people, you're like almost one-on-one, which is pretty stunning. So you got to do your first to get to your second. You got to, you know, the software, you got to get to version 1.2, but you can't get to 1.2 unless there's 1.0. So I encourage people to do their first event. We guide you through all that because there is massive amounts of fear. There's all that stuff. You know, It's about my first Pride event. We had 66 people registered and I was humiliated. I was like, oh my gosh, you know, I'm teaching this. I should have had, you know, thousands. Now thousands will cost you a massive amount of money for Facebook.
Quantity, not quality, quality, not quantity.
Well, that's the point, right? So here's the thing. We have 42 people that were on when I made the offer. We did really well with sales. I mean, we did really, really well with sales, which, and I've been doing this for years. So, you know, it was what was expected. I didn't do well with people. But here's the point. I spent zero money on advertising, not a penny. And so my friends that are marketing and, you know, collaborating, we have 42 people. And they said, what's your ad spend? I said zero. They're like, what? You know, we spent thousands, you know, and I got nothing. I spent nothing. I had 66, you know, so. There's beauty in that. You don't, size does not matter in this case. Quality is doing it. You're right, matters. Getting that right, the right fit audience in there, you can make a fortune. And here's the beautiful thing. I love this part. Once you dial this in, you can stop doing all the rest of the peripheral BS you've been doing, all the crazy stuff, all the, you know, no more. But by the way, that's a technical demo. Now, think about this. If you're able to do an event, you have, say, 50 people in the room, you know, 10% of them enroll. And by the way, you should be doing 20 minimum the way I train you. So it's 10 people and you have a $5,000 offer, that's 25 grand in a weekend.
Yeah.
And frankly, you can do it in a one day as well with something that's that low in price. How many of those you got to do over the course of a year to make a lot of money? I got to tell you, I was traveling and speaking literally on stages. I would do free lectures twice a day for 3 to 4 days a week. And then I would fulfill on what we sold in that 3-day lecture, in those free lectures, into a 3-day event 10 days later. I was pretty much going all the time throughout Southeast Asia and the US. 3 months, three weekends out of the month, I was doing 3-day events. Made a fortune for everybody else, not for me. Now it's mine. Now it's yours. You do an event a month, one event a month, or you do bigger numbers. I'm talking small numbers just because you're getting started. If you have a couple hundred people in the room, you have a $10,000 offer and sell just even 10%. Do the math, a couple hundred thousand dollars in a weekend.
Yeah.
In the math don't lie. So you gotta get there. I don't want to freak people out and go, oh, I can't do this, I'm not worthy. Bullshit. Right. But the thing is, you gotta get to the first one to get the ski legs, to get the confidence. Remember when you got on a bicycle and you're like, I can't do it, Daddy. You know, there's training where I still can't do it. I'll fall over myself. You know, you get up and it's like, what was ups about? You know, it's like a roller coaster, you know? You're like, and then you get on and you go up to the top of you and now you're screaming, talking in tongues, you're scared to death. You go down, you're screaming, your hands up like this, and then you get off the roller coaster. What do you say? Let's go do it again. So that's what this is.
Well, some people do. Some people barf, but we're going to assume that people aren't going to barf here.
I think, you know, she barfed before she goes on. She's been doing this for decades and she's still terrified, but she still does it. Oh. You know, so there, yeah, apparently she does. There is that fear, and there's also a lot of excitement, and you'll have the excitement for everything. But each time it's fresh and it's new and it's a different audience. But the fun part of it is when you see people, you know, I'm looking at you and you know, you're smiling, you can see them, you can call them out, you can talk to them, you can be more intimate. People like Russell Brunson are saying it's more intimate than he's ever experienced, because here's the thing that he's quoted as saying, and I've got him on video saying this. When you're in a ballroom with this 5,000 people, you only see the first few rows. There's lights in your face. You can see. They're watching that video. They don't see you either. But now, I mean, I'm like, I see you. I mean, I see you right there, and I can talk to you. You know, and I'll look up to the camera, and I'm pointing out, Juliet, I see you. You know, I see, or somebody's yawning or whatever. I see them, and I'll call them out. It's all the more you. So, you know, and you can be as cheeky as you want, and it's fun to do. Because now, it, you know, people call these virtual events. These are real. I call them digital events. Virtual means it's not real. This is real. My mom and I talk pretty much every day, sometimes more than once a day. And we've always had, ever since I left the States 10 years ago, you know, we've always had this communication. This is our reality. When I go back to see her in Florida, you know, we're connected, but this is our reality, and it's real time, and it's close, and it's connected, and it's dedicated. And, you know, it's like, even a telephone call isn't real. It's always been real. Now it's just, we have video. So we get to be really, and people really connected, and people make friends. I mean, my goodness, we just did an event just a few days ago, and we had five people presenting, actually six people presenting, team of five plus one of our speakers. And they did it as a team, and now they can't wait to do the next one. They bonded. Strangers from all across, from five different countries. Wow. Bonded for real. Yeah, we had New Zealand, Australia, Singapore, Hong Kong, and the Philippines. All different presenters, my students. Yeah. So you create communities you never could have done before. So, you know, if you're watching this right now, which obviously you are, you wouldn't be here, right? That was intelligent. If you're not excited about this, I'd say something is probably wrong with you. This is the most exciting thing, and this biggest opportunity ever, because the ability to serve people on a global basis, huge audience that you may never been able to do before. It's amazing. And by the way, it's a 24-hour business. So if you're a night owl, do your programs at night.
Yeah.
I just did a daytime. Finally, I did a daytime show for the first time in like forever, because we did it for Asia Pacific. Otherwise, typically I'm doing USA time zones, and it's like, it's an all-nighter, you know, yep. pull out the lights, you know,
great.
Okay, I'm willing to do it. So yeah, that's it.
So where do we find your program? You have one coming up. You're one of your 3-dayers coming up very soon.
I do. So Pride's coming up on the 22nd, 23rd, 24th. It's a Friday, Saturday, Sunday of this month of January. You can go to joinpride.com to get some details on that. I also have some gifts for you as well. I love giving away stuff. So if you go to, and we'll put this in the show notes so you have it as well. So, you know, it's like, if you're jogging right now, this will do you no good, right? So make sure you go to the show notes, find the link, click the link, and get yourself in there. And there may be even some coupon codes for you and stuff too that Juliet and I will negotiate. So, I'd recommend you go to the show notes and get to that page like right now. I have a book called Nice Guys Finish First, and it's pretty great book. So there's a link to that as well, and it's free, but for right now. But only for right now. We gotta go there.
That's great. Thank you. I love the way you assume I do show notes. No, we do. I'm just kidding.
Very professional in many ways.
Yes, we are professional. Well, Ken, thank you as usual. It's always great. You guys, I'm so excited. I didn't even notice till now. He actually put a shirt on for this. Normally he struts around in like a t-shirt and doesn't comb his hair, and he's got his glasses on. And I just feel so privileged that he dressed for me today. Yeah, there you go. All right. Thank you. It's what?
Juliet, I charge more when I wear those. Say, I gave you this.
Yes, it is.
I adore you. Thank you for the opportunity. You guys, if this interests you, check out the link, joinpride.com. We'll get you there. We'd love to see you. It's an amazing event. Plan 3 outrageous days. It'd be awesome.
It is. Thank you.